Hello friends, today we are going to talk about cosmology. And cosmology itself means cosmos and logos, where cosmos is universe and logos is science. The universe is everything we can see and a lot that we can't see. It is the totality of everything that exists, including all physical matter and energy, the planets, stars, galaxies, and the contents of intergalactic space. There are three theories regarding the origin of the universe. The Big Bang Theory by E. George Lemaître, Steady State Theory by Thomas Gold and Herman Bondi, and the Pulsating Universe Theory by Dr. Alan Sandys. We are going to focus on the Big Bang Theory. So before we get started, here is a fast fact. What's in a name? The term Big Bang was coined by Fred Hoyle in 1950 to illustrate to his radio listeners the difference between it and his own theory, steady state, where the universe has no beginning. The universe is about 13.8 billion years old, and at its beginning, it looked nothing like as it does today. Yet, everything in today's universe did exist in some form back then. In the beginning, the universe was a hot and dense ball of radiation energy containing particles like protons, neutrons, and electrons. It all started with the Big Bang, a kind of explosion that would not only go on to produce all the matter in the universe, but also mark the start of time. According to Big Bang theory, the universe began from a single point and then started expanding to what it is now. It's still expanding. As the space expanded, the universe cooled and matter formed. In 1/1000th of a second, tiny radiation particles produce tiny particles of matter, and these combine to form the first ever chemical elements, hydrogen and helium. Some areas in the universe contain slightly more hydrogen and helium, and these shrank to form the first stars. Nuclear reactions inside the stars produced many other chemical elements, including carbon and oxygen. The elements in the universe today were created in the moments after the Big Bang, as the universe started cooling. Eventually, the galaxies and planets that we know today got formed. Sun was also formed containing elements like hydrogen of about 73%, helium of about 25%, and a small quantities of other elements including oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, silicon, magnesium, neon, iron, and sulfur. Everything in the universe produces energy. We all produce energy when we exercise, and light energy is produced by nuclear reactions inside stars. To get more information about stars, kindly watch our next video.